So once you've finished a baseline, the next time you go for a run, you'll see a recommended target zone and exercise. In this case, it's recommending that we work on our foot strike, but another time you go running, it might be, for example, your cadence, or maybe your stride length, or any other number of parameters we can measure. For now, we'll use foot strike for the demo. The dashed line you can see there is our baseline. The green zone is the recommended target zone that we're going to work towards. When I press start, again you'll get a countdown and audio feedback telling you
run what started, aim to land on your forefoot.
The audio feedback will guide you as to what you have to do with each session you're running. We focus on one element at a time, so in this run we'll focus on foot strike, but in another run it might be another parameter such as cadence or stride length. If you're running in the target zone, you won't receive any additional feedback, but if you drift outside that target zone, then the system will give you an alert and allow you to make a correction in real time. Of course, you can always see exactly where you're running and how you're running. The color of the line represents the zone in which you're running. In this case, we're in the green zone, so the line is green. But you might find if you're running uphill or downhill that your technique is affected, and that's why the map feature is very important. Here we can see the pressure under your feet, which for now just gives us an indication that the sensors are working and shows how the foot is responding in the shoe. But when we finish, we can see that in more detail.
Run completed.
So now, again, we can give it a star rating to give an indication of how good we felt during the run and any injuries that occurred during the run itself. And after the run, we can scroll through every step we took, locate elements of interest, and then look at that particular step, pressure profile, and the orange line will show the roll off of the foot. In this case, we can see the profile of all the parameters that have been measured, not just the target zone in this case, which was foot strike. If you're successfully able to maintain your parameter in the green zone, then the next time you go running, you'll find that it makes another recommendation for a different element of your running technique to work on. So this is the basics of the coaching AI, but of course you can always override the AI yourself. If you want to, you can edit your own target zones and create your own targets, or you can receive information from a coach and accept their recommendations for how you should be running as well.